My name is Emil Nielsen. I study philosophy at Copenhagen University, and I have been in camping here for 23 days now, trying to make our university recognize the genocide in Gaza and cut all ties to Israel via investments, purchase agreements, and academic ties. And today, we got the university to divest from three companies, all companies on the UN blacklist, which they have been invested in, Airbnb, eDreams, and Booking.com, following our pressure on the university. This is a big win, but we're only encouraged by it. It shows that our protests have been working. They are caving into our demands slowly. We're not done at all. We have yet to make them give us any long-term commitments, guarantees that they will never again invest in these companies profiting off the illegal settlements. We have yet to make them boycott their ties to Israeli academic institutions such as Hebrew University of Jerusalem. But we're on our way, and we will stay here, and we will keep fighting, knowing now that we can win.
My name is Sarah. I am 19 years old and I study law here in Copenhagen University. I was born in Denmark, but both of my parents were Palestinians. And we have these six demands. Copenhagen Uni has met three of them. They have met the divestments from companies that operates on illegal settlements. They have only pulled their investments from three companies, Airbnb, eBooking and eDiego, which is like eDreams. They have also met the demand that they open all of their investments to the public, so it's a transparent investment portfolio. They have also sort of met the last demand, which is to acknowledge Palestinian struggle and to help their Palestinian students in these hard times, but they haven't really come through with the demands. We are not done yet. We still have three demands left. We have the academic boycott. We have the agreements they have with settlements that also operates in illegal settlements. And we have the last one, which is to recognize this situation as a genocide. We are not done yet. As I said, we are now focusing on the academic boycott of Copenhagen University's ties with the Israeli University in Tel Aviv, which also operates on stolen land.
وبعد مرور 23 يوم من اعتصام طلاب جامعة كوبنهاجن فقد استجابت إدارة الجامعة جزئيا من خلال سحب الاستثمارات من قائمة الأمم المتحدة السوداء، وهي توقيف استثماراتها مع ثلاث شركات: الإيدريم، الإير بي أن بي، بوكينج دوت كوم، واستجابوا لمطلب الشفافية الكاملة فيما يتعلق باستثماراتهم، وكذلك استجابوا لمطلب الاعتراف بالوضع الصعب للطلاب الفلسطينيين. هذا يأتي بعد إصرارهم على الشروط الستة التي وضعوها في بداية الاعتصام، وهي الاعتراف بالإبادة الجماعية وإدانتها، والدعوة إلى الوقف الفوري لإطلاق النار ورفع الحصار عن غزة. ثانيا، سحب استثماراتها من الشركات التي تستفيد من أو تشارك في احتلال فلسطين. ثالثا، تقديم شفافية مالية كاملة بخصوص استثماراتها. رابعا، إنهاء عقود الشركات التي تستفيد من أو تشارك في احتلال فلسطين. خامسا، مقاطعة أكاديمية بإنهاء التعاون المؤسسي مع المؤسسات الأكاديمية الإسرائيلية. سادسا، الاعتراف بالوضع الصعب للطلاب الفلسطينيين. وهذا ويبقى الاعتصام مستمر. ماهر حشاش، جامعة كوبنهاجن.